respectful distance, they must stick with the family around the clock. The team in Chile uses the same tactic with the pumas, following them by day and by night.
Okay, get the lights, Pete.
Filming from a vehicle keeps cameraman Luke Barnett mobile.
Okay, left hand down a bit.
And discreet.
Cat's coming back. It's been coming back. Okay, I'm gonna cover up. I don't want the cat to see me staring straight back out, so I've covered my face up.
But when they do lose sight of the pumas, they have some new technology to put to the test.
It's possibly the first time this thermal camera's been put on the drain.
The camera's designed for use in a science lab. Pete had to devise a special rig just to attach it to the drone.
All right, let's get this thing in the air.
And it's temperamental. Sometimes a simple loose wire means he's flying blind. But when it works, it opens up a new perspective on the mountains at night.
There's actually a herd of guanaco right in front of me. I mean, you'd never know. You can't see a thing other than through the camera.
And a thermal image allows them to pick out the puma regardless of its camouflage. With cameras in the air and on the ground, the crew get to know the mother and cubs and capture their struggles and tender nature in the dark.
That's amazing. She really needed to feed, so that's amazing.
And those cubs will grow nice and fast.
Day is finally dawning after the long Arctic night. And the Svalbard team's persistence also pays off.